Okay, first, what we have is how to drive clients to your location, part one. And actually, you can download this online, this series of questions in part one. So we want to offer to our online community as well as our in-house training class. So in the series of questions, first thing that we asked in the series of how to drive your clients, how to drive clients to your location, part one, the first thing we want to know is your business name. Okay, why we want to know what is your business name is because what in your business name is your communication. Your communication is important. All business dealings, you're just actually communicating with the consumer. So we want to know the communication. What are you saying in your business name to your consumer? Is your name a complicated name where it's not actually communicating to the consumer what it is actually that you do? So I learned a long time ago with different names, and I want to make sure my first name when I came out in the hair care industry or in business was a long name with my name. And now in today's market, people are not really concerned about your personal name. They're more concerned about what it is that you have to offer them. So in communicating, what is your business name? Is your business name saying exactly what you have to offer? Okay, in communicating the business name, what is it that you're offering? All right, offering, communication, what is your business name? We want to make sure we know that whatever you're communicating to the consumer in your name. Now, some people, I've seen names now range from, I really believe it's very important. I've seen names like, I hope I'm not offending nobody, but Dada Cuts. Now, let's look at that name, Dada Cuts. Dada Cuts is something that the actual business owner came up with saying that this is my name. Now, Dada Cuts, who is Dada? Who is Dada? What is Dada? That's what you're asking the consumer, saying, what is Dada? So when we're saying cuts, we're looking at cuts can mean dog grooming, or is it haircuts? Now, this is so important because before you spend major money in advertisement, you want to make sure that you portray the right communication to the consumer. So Dada Cuts is not really saying what it is you have to offer the consumer. So your business name is very important when you actually choose a name. So if you're saying that if you want to drive clients to your location, you have to be clear about your communication in what is your name. Dada Cuts does not explain anything. It does not relate to the consumer. They have to actually, I believe in a model that if a person have to ask what it is that you do, your name is wrong. So first thing we want to do is look at your name. Okay. Second thing that we want to look at is how many years you've been in business. Now, you would say, why is this important? Okay, how many years you've been in business? If you've been in business 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if you've been in business 5 years, then that community that you're in pretty much know what it is that you offer. Okay, because they probably passed by, looked in, seen something that they figured out what it is that you do. But the deal is, if 5 years you have more, as you say, I would say in. Excuse me. If you have more people coming out and leaving than you have coming in, there is a problem. In other words, you're losing more clients, but you're not bringing more clients in. So more are going out than they are coming in. So in other words, I always use a rule of thumb of asking people, well, you know, how did you hear about us? Or, you know, where did you find out about us? Because we want to find out what that is. You have more people going out than you have coming in. There's a problem. That directly relates to people driving to your business. So what's happening is You may want to take the time out. If you've been in business 2 to 3 to 5 years, what are they saying about your business? What are they saying about your business? What are they saying? This is the most important question that you could ask, you know, those that come in, or ask those that maybe have left your business and they're gone for a while and you happen to see them. Ask them the question, why did you leave? Again, we said we got more people going out than coming in. So you want to ask that question, what are they saying about your business? You may find out some interesting things. They may say that, well, the lines are too long, or, you know, just small stuff. They're rude. They're not, their appearance, you know, things like this. It really affects your bottom line about driving people, more new people to your business, because you want to make sure that the communication that you're giving to the consumer, you're saying that we're open for business. Another thing that we're finding out is that the hours that are on your door, well, they'll say, well, you know, that they cut hair good in there, or they do good business in there, but, you know, it's not actually real good business because they're never there on time. You never can find the person. So that's the thing. What are they saying about your business? Okay, another thing that we want to look at is we want to look at the zip code. Now, this is important about your zip code. I've talked to a lot of people in consulting with business, especially in the hair care salon industry. People may come into this industry and say, well, I want to offer such and such, such and such. Well, you may want to go in, let's just give you a prime example. You want to go into an area in the zip code. Let's just give a zip code 75063. Okay, in that zip code, the total household income in that zip code is $24,000 per year. $24,000 per year. And it's $24,000 per year, but 75% of it are renters. Okay? $24,000 per year, and 75% of it is renters. Now, what that lets me know is, if $24,000, you can't go into that market, you can, but charging $250 for some weave. It just, you know, the market can't bear that kind of price. So you may be in the wrong zip code for the services that you're offering, and you're wondering why you can't drive clients to your location. And another thing, when we say 75% renters, what that means is you're going to have a turnover of clients. Every year, people are moving in and out of these apartments, so they're going to come in and out. So you're going to always have to do advertisement or be visible in the community by your business name, saying exactly what you do, the years you've been in business, the zip code. We want to look at the 75% renters. I'm getting off track, but 75% renters. So you will know that if you look up, and how you do this is, only thing you have to do is Google your zip code. And what's going to pull up is, it's going to call citydata.com. I think it's citydata or something like this. And learn how to read your demographics, because you may be offering the wrong service in the wrong zip code, and wonder why people are saying that either you're too high or you're too low or something. Something is going on there why you can't drive clients to your location. So you want to look at your zip code. Now, I hope that was beneficial to you. Now, the next part that we're looking at is, I covered this in the name, but I really want to go back over it. What I want to cover is, why did you choose your business name? Okay. Now, why did you choose your business name?